Good morning from Estonia, part two, and Helsinki. We've finished up the week here in Estonia, and we actually transferred Airbnbs to another amazing host that we worked with, and it was so fantastic. The Airbnb that we went to was directly in the middle of Old Town, and I finally got to meet the host that I've been following on Instagram for a couple months now. Her name is Alice, and she was just so kind and amazing. The apartment was extremely clean, had a jacuzzi overlooking Old Town, and you are right in Old Town, so you can look out your window and see the history from your very own apartment window. Once we checked out of there, we took a ferry over to Helsinki, Finland, and I thought it was going to be quite a small little ferry, maybe 3 floors or so, but to our surprise, it was actually a huge cruise ship. This thing was so large, when it parked, there were over 100 cars that came out of the bottom of it.
Here comes our ferry! Who would have thought that this is considered a ferry? This is a giant cruise ship, you guys. This is huge.
There were 8 different floors. We did not rent a cabin because it was only a 2-hour ride from Estonia to Finland.
Going to Finland.
First time going on a ferry. Surprisingly, it's just exactly like an airport. Gates and all. Check in, go to your gate, wait for the boat. I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and how come we're so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're. And then once we got there, we just found a really close hotel because the very next day we would be traveling to our next country. So in Helsinki, we didn't do too much because we knew we were leaving the next morning. We got to our hotel. We did end up stumbling upon the international market that is outside, and there's all these tents up and people from countries around the world set up booths and sell their goods, which is super cool.
And all of these moments just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do, or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together.
We did find this amazing sushi place. There are sushi restaurants everywhere in Helsinki. And when we went to check in, I asked the check-in woman, you know, is there a sushi place that's better than others? I know where we come from, some are higher quality than others. And she said in Helsinki, they're all super high quality sushi. So we found this sushi buffet, and normally I don't like buffets, but this place was incredible. They had all different kinds of sushis. I only really liked cooked sushis, and they were constantly putting out fresh sushis, and that was, we joke, like, we went to Helsinki just to eat sushi, but we had to go there to catch our cruise ship to go to our next country. I wanted to talk a little bit this week about our travel days and how everything is really going while traveling abroad. We constantly get asked from our friends and family, how's it going? And, you know, we say it's going great. And then they always say, but really, how's it really going? And it really is going better than expected. We're constantly changing time zones, and a lot of people had kind of instilled fear in us that that was going to not be so easy on the kids. And everyone has adapted so well. We still take, like, Penelope still takes our daily naps, and we go to sleep. And constantly changing time zones really isn't a big deal because we're only ever changing a couple hours here and there. Do you want to say anything about the sushi restaurant we went to?
Mm-hmm. It has, like, some ice cream with ice cream sauce.
Mm-hmm. And we saw this huge building with a giant duck head on it.
Uh-huh. What was very funny, and can we say we say?
Say what?
And lay the eggs.
What else do we want to talk about? So our travel days.
In Holland, it was really nice because all the people were super nice to us and we really liked it. There was my mommy.
Oh, Holland was our favorite, right?
And then for my birthday at Estonia, we went to a water park, and I had a donut cake with one coffee in the middle.
Just what you wanted.
Uh-huh.
All right. So I'm going to talk about our travel days now, okay?
Okay.
So we usually do travel days once a week, and sometimes before I left for this journey around the world, I never really did well on planes. I was very anxious all the time, kind of got plane sickness. And since we've started traveling, my anxiety about going on airplanes has completely diminished. I do so well on airplane rides now. The kids are just incredible. Penelope goes right to sleep on every single flight. Preston puts on his headphones and plays a little game. And Tyler just works, so. Travel days really aren't that stressful. Some are better than others, and we certainly have our fair share of child meltdowns, I'm sure as every family does. And we only share usually the good parts about traveling. So we have our fair share of, you know, hard times as well. But being in a new country each week totally makes up for it. And, you know, we would have these meltdowns with our children even if we were home or wherever home is going to be. So it's really just not so much about traveling, it's just having kids is hard, and that's the way it is. So here's some clips that I put together just to show everyone how it's going and how we can't wait for the rest of this journey. I can't believe we're already 2 months in and we only have 10 more months to go. That's super shocking. It's super early here on Sunday morning, like 7 a.m. So trying to put this video together before I'm not gonna have service anymore. So excuse the face. I know I look really tired. It's cause I am, but hope you guys enjoy these videos. And next week is going to be a really epic country.
Yeah, it is. I love my mommy.
Oh, I love my sonny.
Peace out.
Peace out.
combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. And our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on me so hard. And it's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between, with only two, just me and you. Not so many things we got to do, but places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.